good evening and welcome to the 2015 International WFDDA Playoffs live from Dallas, Texas. I am Double H here with Hammer Abby. Welcome.
Thank you.
We were just talking before the game that we have some great spots during the postseason. There's intense and then there's roller derby intense. And I think the thing that describes this game is there's nervous and then there's roller derby nervous. And the game that we have today has two teams on edge, Philly Roller Derby taking on Rat City Roller Girls. Let's talk about these teams.
Let's do it. This should be a real fun match. Philly came in as the number 3 seed in this tournament. They are 10th ranked in the WFTDA. They are going up against Rat, who came in as the 4 seed and is number 15 in the WFTDA right now. They are battling it out for third place, so if Philly wins, they will maintain their seeding and go on to championships in St. Paul this November. And if Rat wins, it's a bit of an upset, and they would punch their tickets to championship instead. And it's interesting to note that these teams have met in sanction play just 3 times over the last several years. The first one in 2009, Philly winning in a blowout at ECDX. The next 2 times in 2010 and 2011, Rat City winning in battles at the Wild West Showdown. So this would be it's just going to be a super interesting match. I have no idea what to expect.
It's really hard to describe the climate right here, right now. Both of these teams absolutely on edge. Let's get to these rosters so we can get into the game. For the Rat City Roller Girls, we've got 0, Energizer Bunny. Number 02, Leanne Evans. Number 12, Lacey Ramon. Number 187, Kay Beasy. 22, Sammy Automatic. Number 243, Genevieve Moore. 316, M. Jensen. 321, Missile America, that's a.k.a. Kayla Gaska. Number 4, Suki Dicey. Number 49, Beck. Number 5, Zena. Number 53, Raven Seaward. Number 911, Luna Negra. That's the Lunicorn. And 94, H-Bots.
And for Philly Roller Derby Liberty Bells today, we have 00, Meryl Stripper. 06 is Michelle Castro. 15 is Kill Martin. 152, Herman Monster. 18 is Vanessa V. Diva Sights. 247 is Devoid of Mercy. 313, Emma Knock You Out. 33 is Legend of the Hit and Trample. 401 is Tarantula, 434 Wolf, 85 Teflon Donna, 86 Wax Poetic, 957 Ginger Vitus, and 99 Russian Bayou.
So one of the things that we have been talking about throughout this tournament is lead jammer percentage on the season. Philly has the second lowest lead jammer percentage on the season in this tournament at 42%. Rat City sitting at 56% lead jammer status on the season. So a bit more success for Rat City's jammers overall this season. On the line, though, Philly has Vanessa V. Diva Sights, number 18, facing off against Luna Negra, the Lunicorn, 911.
And real quick, our head referee for this is Judge Knott, joined by Werner Von Baum, De Cruel Hand Luke, Cat A. Kilsom, Pantychrist, Jesse Jackass, Rage Appropriate, and Official Lee Hated.
Philly taking the back line off the whistle. Luna Negra, though, out on the outside to become lead jammer status. Vanessa hung up on the inside of the pack. Taking a move to the outside, she's able to get past a blocker or two. Rat City spreading out defensively. Luna coming in for a scoring run. She makes it around the outside, looks at her bench carefully and says, what do you want me to do? They say, keep going.
Well, V Diva had not yet broken out of the pack. Last minute hit coming around to turn two, dropped her to the inside and she had to recycle all the way back.
So coming back against this four wall, Luna is able to get through on the inside, draws first blood. 2 times for Rat City, so points going on the board for Rat City. And there it is, 8 points and Philly nothing right now.
So this is the first time that these two teams have met at playoffs. And it's not going to be the first time either of them will have gone to champs if they win. Rat's been there 3 times, Philly 5 times in the past. And by the way, if you want to talk to us on Twitter, you can use the hashtag Talk2WFTDA. And I'm told that there's a watch party at the Rat's Nest for this game right now.
Missile America, a.k.a. Kayla Gaska, 321, jamming for Rat City. She is pushing against a 4 wall at the front that Philly has, braced by Tarantula. In the back, Herman Monster, looking for a way around, finds a little bit of space, but comes up against Suki Dicey on the outside. Pushing to the inside, though, between turns 1 and 2, she's able to make it through. And she is going to get, there's the out-of-play call. She is lead jammer for Philly. And still working on it, Kayla Gaska around the pack, through for her initial. 2 blockers headed to the Derby Supply penalty box, though, for Philly. Herman Monster getting a bit of help from her pivot, Gingivitis, that is also her sister, hooking a hip around to grab a point or two. She checks the conditions, gets forced to the inside, and calls it.
Boy, two fast-moving packs on that jam for sure, too.
And that was 1 point for her effort.
All that skating in 1 point, but every point matters in the game of inches of roller derby. 27 minutes, 50 seconds left in the first half of gameplay here at the Irving Convention Center near Dallas, Texas. And we want to give a special shout out to the Dallas Derby Devils for hosting this weekend.
Number 15, Kill Martin on the fast girl start line against Genevieve Moore. And lining up at the pivot line, Rat City's got a full complement of blockers. Philly only two, but Teflon Donna makes use of her skill as the pivot on the outside. And just sneaking past, though, is Genevieve Moore. And Kill Martin still looking for some help from Castro, and Teflon Donna not able to get past the opposing blockers in the back. Getting forced down, though, at turn one, Genevieve Moore.
Nice work, just a two-person blocking pack there for Philly for a minute. Now rejoined by a third. Still did a great job defending against the jammer on that turn one there.
Meryl Stripper popping forward to offer a little bit of offense to Kill Martin. Kill Martin taking a knee. Getting recycled there by that three-person brace now from Rat City. Now four-person brace. Teflon Donna, meanwhile, working on turn one with Genevieve Moore. And really static pack here. We've got three in the back, two bridges, and three in the front. Now popping back to offer another bridge in front. Rat City recycles Kill Martin all the way in the far straightaway to the near straightaway.
Near?
Far.
All the way back. Backwards derby happening right now. Both jammers coming back to turn four, starting behind the fast girl skate start line now.
And that's the pivot. Lacey Ramon giving a little bump to Kill Martin as she comes up, still trying to break the pack. And that is Meryl Stripper coming up to offer again some more offense as Castro heads to the Derby Supply penalty box for Philly. Now only two defending in the back. And again, Russian Bayou with the takeout to the outfield.
And she's going to call it off, not liking the looks of that drawback anymore. Rat City now up to 14. Philly just one shortly into this jam. Opening up a little bit of an early lead here, Rat City. Philly running into a quick penalty trouble there. They do have one person sitting in the Derby Supply penalty box right now.
That is number five, Xena, on the fast girl start line for Rat City, facing off against Vanessa V. Diva Seitz.
Going to pull out her chakram, try to slice through this pack. I had to make at least one reference.
Xena fighting a three-person brace. Tarantula is at the four of that brace. She's able to keep Xena behind her, but Xena trips past her on the inside to become lead jammer. Now refocusing their attention on Vanessa Seitz, who's been recycled, offering some offense. And then partner blocking up front from Gingivitis and Tarantula.
This is three of four lead jammer statuses for Rat City so far in the game.
So as we discussed, a bit more lead jammer percentage on the season overall from Rat City playing out just as predicted here. A three-person brace in the back for Xena. And up front, Vanessa V. Diva Seitz also fighting a three-person brace of Rat City.
Philly's pack losing one blocker to the penalty box now, so they've just got two on the track, and that's going to give a shot for Xena to get through and pick up a grand slam for Rat City.
And she takes a look at her bench and says, should I call it? Nope, going to keep going. Vanessa still in the pack, finally able to break forward, just one to beat. That was Jensen. She does so and is through for her initial. And now fighting her way through on another point scoring run, Xena getting forced to the ground decides, yes, now I'm going to call it.
Rat City lost one blocker at the end there, too. We have a timeout being called on the track for Philly, taking a minute.
And that's a good time. We've got a score of Rat City 28, Philly 1, 23 minutes and 56 seconds left in the first period.
Sickening seconds left.
Sickening seconds, describing how I feel on the inside.
Oh, hey, by the way, Fast Girl Skates, one of our great sponsors this weekend. Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com. 8 years of dedicated to making a faster you. That's Fast Girl Skates. And hey, guess what? It's the 10th anniversary of the WFTDA. We're celebrating 10 years of real, strong, athletic, revolutionary leadership in roller derby. congratulations on 10 years to all of us.
Yay! And both of these teams having a big hand in that as well, Hammer Abbey.
Longtime WFTDA members, both Rat and Philly. Sort of a nice old school matchup here.
Number 434, Wolf on the Fast Girl start line for Philly. 911, Luna Negra, a.k.a. the Lunicorn. Now, Philly with the pack advantage here. They've got three. They're taking the back line on this one. Up in front, Rat City with two blockers on the track. At the whistle, Wolf trying to find a way around the outside, recycled so fast by Rat City's blocker. Same thing on the inside for Luna Negra, and that is going to be a penalty assessed to the Lunicorn. This is a lead jammer status. Philly, their first in the game. Coming around on a scoring run, full complement of blockers here from Philly. Just three on the track for Rat City. Giving a little bit of information to her blockers about her offensive strategy. Popping forward, getting some help on the outside from Teflon Donna, the pivot. Coming forward, Wolf has one to beat at the front. She's pushing and turning like she's unwrapping herself from a carpet and is through for 5 points.
That was a track cut penalty, by the way, on Luna Negra. Now getting released again from the Derby Supply penalty box, re-entering action on the track.
So a full complement on the floor now. 5-on-5, Luna out of the Derby Supply penalty box and recycled as Wolf getting some help from Teflon Donna, who drops back to bridge. Wolf pushing on the inside, trying to scratch as many points out of this as possible, but Rat City's blocker's doing a really good job with this tripod here.
And that tripod we've been seeing all weekend having such effectiveness. If you can have three people holding back that jammer, you can send one to help. Huge hit on
Wolf. And that is going to be a low block penalty, but that's 5 points assessed. And so Philly on the board with 10 additional points to meet their one. Rat City 28, Philly 11.
Adam skates, train hard, play smart. Skate Adam. They've been a proud partner of the WFTDA then and now.
Four on the floor on the line for Philly. They are taking the back line. This is number 247, Devoid of Mercy, on the Fast Girl start line against Kayla Gaska for Rat City with only two blockers at the front. Devoid of Mercy coming up against those two, but Carmen Getsem is one of them. Lacey Ramon taking Devoid of Mercy to the inside. And she's able to get past Ramon and is through to become lead. She looks behind her, very confused. I wasn't sure she was expecting to get lead there, but she did. She almost accidentally called it off, Hammer.
Yeah, and surprising, like really great work from Philly's defense, even though they were short, holding back.
So she trips through to grab an additional 4 points for Philly and calls it. Philly 15, Rat City 28.
So that is now a 3-3 lead jammer status for the teams, even Steven here. 21 minutes, 20 seconds left in the first half of gameplay. Some early penalty trouble here for both teams, frequently down to short packs on the track. Right now, the Derby Supply penalty box does have one blocker from each team sitting in it, including the pivot for Philly, which is never the person you want to have out in case you need to do a star pass.
So we have 3-on-3 for blockers, but right through the inside line is Xena, number 5, lead jammer for Rat City. Herman Monster working on two defenders up at the front, including Jensen, the pivot, who's going to get a penalty for out-of-play engagement. So through is Herman Monster on her initial. Coming through is Xena, looking to her bench for some communication. The pack speeds up, and only two blockers per team, and now coming out of the penalty box, Ginger Vitus.
Yeah, Suki Dicey and H-Bots, the only two blockers on the track right now for Rat, dealing with the Philly pivot here, trying to get their jammer through. Pack's moving at very fast speeds right now.
And there's going to be an out-of-play penalty assessed to the pack for Rat City. Herman Monster continuing. She gets one no pass, no point on that pass. So that's 3 points for her, 4 points for Xena.
Yeah, again, penalty trouble. Really making things difficult here for the packs. All very capable blockers, but difficult to stop these jammers when things are moving that quickly and you're low on people this early in the game.
Emma knock you out, popping forward to perform a little offense, opening a hole for her jammer. Coming back, Xena. Eyeing up the back of the pack, but right there for her is Jensen, her pivot. So that's a few more points here per side. Herman Monster able to steal two.
Yeah, came in super hot at the end there and just stole those 2 points right before the whistles blew. Nice hustle by Herman Monster there for Philly. Now we're sitting at Philly 24, Rat City 36, still holding on to that early lead they were able to build.
And we've got Luna Negra, the Lunicorn, on the line for Rat City against Vanessa Seitz. And we were asked to call her the Lunicorn. She didn't ask us to call her the Lunicorn. Rat City asked us to call her that.
What are you going to do?
You can't say no.
No, you can't say no to Rat City.
And Vanessa Seitz, another person you cannot say no to, lead jammer for Philly. The Lunicorn trying to make her way on the outside, gets shut down in the outside lane, reforming quickly those four blockers for Philly as Vanessa makes another pass on the outside. Five more for Philly.
Yeah, you leave that tiny little bit of outside line open for her, and she takes it. Rat City losing a blocker to the Derby Supply penalty box. Now, again, pack's moving super fast in this jam.
Some confusion in the pack about who's supposed to be doing what, except that Philly's blockers know pretty immediately they need to try to grab a goat, and let's see, they're not successful in grabbing any points, although Vanessa thinks that she should have two.
V-Diva always likes to call, you know, to sort of, you know, how many points she thinks she's going to get at the
Dear
end of the...
Dear jammer referee, here's how many points you should be giving me. Love, Vanessa.
Aw, such good penmanship, a nice little note.
A sticker.
A
heart sticker.
A heart sticker, for sure.
37 Rat City, 29 Philly. Kilmartin on the line against Gaska. Taking the back line is Philly. Three-person brace at the front for Rat City. And right around the outside, Gaska, lead jammer. Kilmartin recycled on the inside. Now she's coming up against two. Now three. Good job from Rat City springing forward. Oh, right around the outside, Kayla Gaska on her toe stops. Philly not ready for her in the back. That's a 4-point, 5-point pass for Rat City. Kilmartin still the break.
Hard to cover those large turns, turn one and turn three, especially if you're not covering that outside line. That is a place where the jammer can use the mathematics of the track to squeak by and just a little bit of an opening.
More carpet unraveling at the front for Kilmartin as she gets through on her initial. Gaska looks behind her, calls it, wonders how many points she's going to grab out of that, and that's going to be 3 points.
So Rat City up to 45 now, Philly at 29. Interesting to note, Philly had some kind of like a slow start in a couple of their games this weekend, but never a team to write off by any means. Philly so far has played Texas and lost 203-99. They won against Dallas 241-114, and same record for Rat, lost against Rose, won against Stockholm.
Number 243, Genevieve Moore on the line for Rat, taking on Wolf, number 434 for Philly. Philly taking the back line, a full complement of blockers for each of these teams. And a braced wall for both of them. Wolf eyeing up the inside, gets a teeny bit of offensive bop on the inside from Meryl Stripper, who now has to become the brace for that third-person wall because she lost a blocker in the process.
Yeah, it was a forearm on Russian Bayou, number 99 for Philly.
So we've got Meryl Stripper in the back. Now Philly's wall in the front as Wolf recycled, but she's through. She's got one to beat. Nice recycling here in the front from Rat City. Almost through was Wolf, but Genevieve Moore, lead jammer for Rat.
Wow, yeah, impressive defensive work there. Even as Wolf was taking those big lurching steps, juking back and forth on the track, trying to get through.
And of course, she's taking the helmet cover off, but it's not going to help her because Ginger Vitus was hung up doing some defensive work at the front as the pivot. And Tarantula going to be going to the Derby Supply penalty box.
So that was the sixth lead jammer call in this game so far for Philly. For Rat City. Philly at just four. Rat City at 49. Philly at 29. So a 20-point gap. That's the kind of math that I can do right there.
That was excellent math.
That was really obvious like that. I'm on it.
And Twitter. Alex Hanna says, I will incorporate unwrapping myself from a roll of carpet into my training. Please do, Alex. Use the hashtag TalkToWFTDA to do so.
It's an ancient practice form right there.
V-Diva through to become lead jammer. Right behind her, though, about a third of a track is Xena. So the pack is racing forward. We've got four blockers in the front, one in the back for Rat, three squished into the middle like a blocker sandwich for Philly. Vanessa comes around the outside. She jukes and grabs a handful of points. She's got two. Again, she is requesting more.
I'm always so interested to see what the interpretation is going to be, like what she thinks versus what the ref thinks.
It's almost as though she's requesting like a rating from a judge.
Right. Like, I mean, and the footwork there definitely merits a rating, I think.
I believe so.
Yeah.
On the Fast Girl Skate start line, Luna Negra, the Lunicorn, 911 for Rat City. Devoid of Mercy, number 247. Up front is Rat City. They've got a full complement of blockers, and they are all working on trying to push Devoid of Mercy out on the inside. Coming up to the Lunicorn, though, a three wall from Philly, not able to hold her. She's lead jammer. All of Philly's blockers now popping back to offer some offense. Devoid of Mercy trying to find a line on the inside, keeps getting shut down and recycled. Moving forward with a little hop, the Lunicorn for five more. And just like that, Rat City 54, Philly 31. Luna coming up behind a four wall and jumping back. Lacey Ramon, Carmen gets him, says, I'm going to just give you a little bit of help here on the inside to try to open up a line. Luna still struggling, and in the back of the pack, Devoid of Mercy yet to make her initial.
Yeah, Rat City doing an excellent job on defense here, brushing off a little bit of offensive strikes that Philly keeps making whenever they got a moment to come back. I mean, Philly doing all the right things, but Rat City just able to brush that off and will pile up on turn one there. Blockers going down left and right as Luna Negra comes around for another scoring pass.
Finally sprung from jail, Devoid of Mercy through for her initial. Luna looks behind her and calls it. So we've got five more points on the board for Luna. 63 Rat City, 31 Philly. It's a difference of 32 points.
Rydell Skates, unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Handcrafting quality roller skates for 70 years. That's RydellSkates.com.
On the Fast Girls start line for Rat City, Kayla Gaska, a.k.a. Miss America, and Herman Monster for Philly Roller Derby. Rat City taking the back wall now. Philly only with three blockers, so they are in the front. Herman Monster pushing forward against that wall, though, through the inside. Kayla Gaska, lead jammer, Rat City, swept away. Onto the outside is Herman Monster, recycled all the way back to the pivot line.
Nice work by Beck and Suki Dicey to knock out Philly's jammer and giving Kayla Gaska that opportunity to come through and grab lead jammer status. That's going to be a five-point grand slam for Rat City on that pass.
Philly trying to wall it up at the back with a three-person brace at the back of the pack.
We've been seeing so much of this three-person thing. I keep saying it, but it's so interesting to see the evolution of a sort of, we had that power box formation you see from Victoria, and now turning into this sort of tripod formation, which frees up that person to go do other extra work as offense or whatever else you can throw them at. And you're seeing teams pick it up through the course of the weekend. Some of them came in with it as a strategy, but you're definitely seeing a lot of the teams learn it and try to incorporate it over the course of the weekend.
Kayla grabs another two on that pass. So Rat City sitting at 70, Philly 31, 11 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first period. I am Double H, and I am here with Hammer Abbey. You are watching WFTDA.TV, the 2015 International Division I playoffs live from Dallas, Texas.
So no real huge penalty trouble for anybody. The highest so far, three for Tarantula on Philly, three for H-Bots on Rat City. A couple scattered here and there, but you're definitely seeing a little bit of penalty trouble in the box, making it difficult for the teams to hold down jammers. And we have Genevieve Moore going head over the top of the pivot for Philly, who will take a penalty for that and go to the Derby Supply penalty box.
That was Ginger Vitus. Out for lead jammer status is Vanessa Seitz. Still not able to break Genevieve Moore in the back. Vanessa Seitz is... Oh, there is going to be a cutting call, and it is going to Genevieve Moore. This is a power jam for Philly.
This is the second power jam for Philly in the game, and a much-needed opportunity for them to put points on the board right here and try to eat away at the lead that Rat City has opened up early in this game.
So that is a five-point pass for Vanessa Seitz. Philly's got three blockers, Rat also with three. And the pack moves forward quickly, a little bit of a jolt, a three-person brace up front for Rat City at turn four. Vanessa, working on the outside, gets through a little bit of an elevator door slam, but she was able to push through and open it. Now we've got four on the track for Philly, three for Rat City. Rat City, that three-person brace in the front, jumping forward to offer a moment of offense is Tarantula. Vanessa gets taken to the outside and calls it.
So it's interesting to note right now the point differentials for the Jammers for Rat City are almost overwhelmingly in the positive, just one down in the negatives, and a lot of negative numbers for Philly Roller Girls. And that's where you're seeing Rat City able to answer points to Philly's scoring passes and also getting lead Jammer on a regular basis here and opening up that lead. It's still 70-45 over Philly.
So we've got Xena, number 5 for Rat City on the Fast Girl start line against Herman Monster. 4-wall on the back from Philly. 3-wall in front now becomes a 4-wall. Carmen gets him out of the penalty box. That's Lacey. And now Herman Monster comes up against the back of Lacey Ramon, looking for a little bit of wiggle room between that tripod. In the back, Philly able to wall it up with a 3-person wall and a brace. And pushing against that wall, Xena able to move it around just enough so that she's able to get her hips passed, as Herman Monster looks like she's moving football sleds forward on the far straightaway with that 3-person brace.
Suki Dicey headed to the Derby Supply penalty box for Rat City, so now they're down at 3 blockers on the track.
Trying to claw her way through past one of her own blockers. On the inside is Xena. Working on Xena, Wax Poetic and Legends, along with Teflon Donna at the front, now turning into a 3-person brace. Monster breaks momentarily. She's able to make it through on her initial. Xena very dramatically waves her arms as she makes it through turn 4.
Well, she did have her own drama on television for a while, so, you know, you got to do everything big and showy.
Monster hesitated for a quick moment as she hit the back of her opposing blockers. I think the kinds of movements Philly's going to need to make in order to stage a comeback here is going to require a little bit more explosiveness than that.
Yeah, going to have to really work hard to just eke out every point that you can. See a little bit of fire under your legs there to try to get through and grab whatever you can, especially at the end right there. Try to get your hips in front of a couple blockers or even just one. Everything's going to matter at this point. Careful clock management.
So 4-on-3 in the pack. Rat City with the advantage at the front. They've got a 4-person brace. Wolf is jamming, but Luna Negra through to become lead jammer for Rat City. Right around the outside, though, behind her. Wolf breaks the pack, about half a pack behind her. Luna coming in hot, slips past Tarantula, calls it Wolf right after her.
Wow.
Not able to grab anything, but that is the explosiveness to which I am referring.
You want to talk about fire in your legs. Wolf's speeding out of the pack there, just speed skating around the track, was impressive. Very, very close run there to try to pick up points. Was able to grab 2 now that I'm looking at the referees. So that hustle made all the difference in the world. Rat City 78, Philly at 47. We've seen now twice in a row Rat City Jammers finding just that tiny bit of inside line open to grab lead jammer status. Philly going to have to watch that.
Kayla Gaska finds the outside line just as you're describing, Hammer Abby. And Vanessa V. Diva Sites also finds the outside line, comes through and is able to have one up front. That is the pivot, Jensen. She's able to make it through for her initial, and coming on a scoring run is Gaska, who's taken out by Teflon Donna, and she calls it, and that is going to be a gain of a point or two, and there's some conversation with the officials, and that's going to be 3 points
all
for
right.
Gaska.
All your derby needs can be met at derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
On the Fast Girl start line for Rat City, number 243, Genevieve Moore, taking on 15, Kilmartin for Philly. Philly taking the back wall again. Rat City up front. We're 5-on-5 as this jam starts. Finding that outside line, or trying to, is Genevieve Moore. I think Philly's going to try to shut that down from now on.
Hear me watching for it.
Gingivitis and Tarantula keeping the outside locked down. Kilmartin getting a little bit of help from Gingivitis, who jumps forward to give her a little bit of offense. More carpet rolling from Kilmartin at the front, but Rat City's right there, reforming that wall in the front. That's Evans, Ramon, KBZ, and Seaward. Kilmartin able to make it past at least one, now has 2 to beat, as one blocker from Seattle heading to the Derby Supply penalty box. Kilmartin recycled, and There is a lead jammer, and it is going to be assessed to Genevieve Moore. There was questions about the legality of Kilmartin's re-entry for a moment, even from her, I think.
Two Rat City players in the Derby Supply penalty box right now. So they're down to just two on the track to help out their jammer. Play defense and a huge
Tarantula.
Blistering hit to the inside by Tarantula to end that jam. 1 point in the air for Rat City at the end. So they're up at 82. Philly now at 47. Just under 4.5 minutes left in the first half. Wow, this has been a fast-moving first half of the game.
So I think Rat City was not excited to have to call that jam because they do have two blockers in the box. They are going to start down two. Philly with a full complement of blockers here on the line. They're going to take the line. That's Vanessa Vidiva-Seitz on the Fast Girls start line against Luna Negra. She's got two to beat Vanessa, and she does quickly. So through to become lead jammer is V Diva. Wax Poetic giving a little bump at the front to two of Seattle's blockers.
V Diva actually pushing on the back of Luna Negra there, kind of helping out with the defense as she was coming around, now meeting up with that tripod of Rat in the front, able to sidestep it though for a 5-point grand slam for Philly.
So recycled in the back with a, there is a Lunacorn in the penalty box, Hammurabi. So this is going to be a power jam for Vanessa. And she gets hung up on the outside. We've got a full complement of blockers. Vanessa takes a look and she sees Luna in the box and she calls it.
Yep, so that was a cut call on Luna Negra. This is her second penalty of the game so far. Another 4 points in the air for Philly at the end of that. V Diva sitting at just slightly less than 50% lead jammer status. She's been out there 7 times, has won it 4 times. Luna Negra also out 7 times, has had lead just 3 times.
So we've got a power jam, a power start for Philly, and we've got a full complement of blockers. There's going to be a timeout taken by Philly. And I did see Paul Williams in the box, the bench manager for Philly. So this is going to be an official review.
Having a little chit-chat out on the track right now gives me an opportunity to tell you real quick that you should make sure you don't miss a minute of the action by purchasing your WFTDA.tv watch pass. Only $15 per tournament, or purchase the D1 and championship bundle for just $60. Live it or stream it live on WFTDA.tv, which is what you are watching or listening to right now, and we appreciate that, but we hope you, you know, think about buying that package so you can watch all of the great action that's coming up next weekend in Jacksonville, for instance, the next D1 playoff that's going to be happening, and then, of course, Champs in November after the next several D1s, of course.
So Paul Williams having some conversation, it looks like, about where and when the penalty was called against Luna Negra, but we will see what Judge Knott has to say.
And the big thing when you look at it is point
difference. Is contesting that the Rat City skater that was sent to the penalty box did not go in the correct direction and is looking for additional time for that penalty. The play is under review.
All right, that's an excellent call for Philly, because they have been struggling with lead jammer status in this game. And as we see, the point differential here, Rat City 82, Philly 56, lead jammer status has meant everything to either one of these teams. So if they can get Luna Negra to be in the penalty box for longer than she currently is, this allows them more opportunity to do some work and make up some ground here.
And I can't say I saw when Luna Negra went to the penalty box to have any insight into as to whether or not she entered correctly or in the right direction. I didn't even notice that she had gone.
So it does look like a determination has been made. And Judge Knott, by the way, has asked me to refer to him as Richie Pickles Frangiosa.
Huh.
So I will do it once, only to really honor his wishes, and then not again ever.
That's a mouthful.
Yes.
Here we go for the decision.
After review, we were unable to determine the direction that the skater went to the box in. However, there is nothing within the rule set that would allow us to add extra time. Therefore, the call stands as is. Thank you.
Okay.
A little rules lesson for us there. Nothing that provides for adding more time for that particular infraction?
We've had a couple of those instances. During this particular tournament, we had a cutting call that someone wanted to have upgraded to an expulsion, and there's nowhere to go in that direction with the cutting call. But with somewhere to go on the line right now is Wolf, number 434 for Philly, getting taken to the inside off the power start. And right away, Rat City's defense shutting her down. She's getting a little bit of assistance on the outside from Ginger Vitus. Out of the penalty box is Luna Negra.
So yeah, nice work by Rat City, really shutting down the power start. The lead jammer stat is still going to go to Philly on this, but they did not make it easy, and it took some time to do it.
A Wolf looked like she was playing hopscotch on the inside to get through that lane. Now getting some help from Vanessa Seitz. Wolf is around on a point scoring run. She's got one at least, coming up against a beautiful three brace here from Rat City. And able to maintain the pack is Rat City, so really slowing things down for Wolf. Bots in particular helping out with that. And through for her initial is Luna. And Wolf spins around, calls it at turn one, and that is going to be a gain of 4 points for Philly.
Rat City 82, Philly at 60 now, just about a minute and a half left in the first half of gameplay here. This is, like I said, been a real fast-moving first half until a couple of those official reviews toward the end. Fast-moving packs as well as a fast-moving game. But Philly clawing away at that lead as best they can, but still having a hard time getting lead jammer statuses, and Rat City maintaining that lead with excellent defense and also having good luck with the jammers getting through and scoring points and having positive differentials for the most part.
Philly on the back line working on Gaska. Herman Monster up front, and beautiful brace work here from Carmen Getsum, the pivot slash captain. Lacey Ramon for Rat City offering an opportunity for her jammer to break, getting lead jammer status for Rat City. Walling it up in the back with a four-person brace. Gaska calling for a little bit of assistance from her blockers, who are maintaining a bit of a bridge to keep that pack together. She says, I don't need you over there. I need you over here.
I need you to complete me. So no points for Philly on that. 3 for Rat City at the end as they continue to open up their lead in front of Philly as we head into probably maybe one more jam before the halftime of this game. This is for the third place slot and a chance to go to championships in St. Paul this November. Be very interested to see what Philly is able to learn at halftime and maybe change up their strategy a little bit and come back out and try to make something happen for them in the second half.
We've got Zena taking on V-Diva. V-Diva through the inside is going to get lead jammer status. Huge move there by Philly, who was down a blocker. Vanessa through the inside, coming up against that four-person square. The brace formation on the outside, getting taken down and holding her face. Holding her face as though she was hit. Vanessa coming back onto the track in a scoring run. Looking to make some movement here for her team. Right behind her, though, taking her opponent, Zena, out at turn three and drawing her all the way back, giving her blockers a second to reset. Zena's not going to fall for it, though.
No.
She says, I'm not going all the way back to turn two. Go ahead and expire time if you want.
Oh, so a little bit of a game of chicken right now. V-Diva just hanging out between turns one and two, and Zena just hanging out of bounds.
Vanessa looks at the box to see how many blockers she can break. And both of them standing, so we've got Russian Bayou making a move. And Rat City very wisely pulling forward to see what they can do, if they can do any jammer trapping, any baby eating.
Smart move by Rat's pack on that. V-Diva has tried that a couple of times this weekend. This was probably the most successful one, and that's going to be a 5-point grand slam.
She asked and was rewarded. She said 5 and was given 5.
Yeah, Rat City picking up 2 on that as well, though. So we are going into halftime with Rat City at 87 over Philly at 65. Such an interesting game happening so far. So much strategery happening out on the track right now. But so far, Rat proving the more successful of the two teams, higher lead jammer status percentage, higher point differential in general. Philly really stuck on some penalty trouble early in that first half. Going to have to clean it up in the second and make a concerted effort to get their jammers through more quickly.
So we did have a number of jammer penalties early on the side of Philly. Rat City had some problems as well, but we did have a couple of issues. And so no jammer penalties for Philly. Let me try that again.
Yep.
But other blocker jammer penalties and 3 for Rat City. Taking a look at the penalty board here.
Tarantula on the side of Philly has 5. So that's a challenge for them. And that is Bot on the side of Rat City, who is sitting on 4 penalties, and that's the most that they have. But a good number of clean blockers still out there for Philly. And as I completely mistook some of those penalties, Philly's jammers are clean right now. They're just not getting through.
Yeah, it's so interesting. So 3 box trips by Rat City jammers right now, but not making that big of a difference. Rat City's defense so good at maintaining and playing with their heads in the game, staying very calm, really good defensive formations, doing all the right things, making all the right adjustments.
And really capitalizing on those moments when Philly's blockers are down in the penalty box.
Right, and that's what's making the difference right now. But not a super huge penalty-heavy game so far in general, just a battle of wits happening on the track. So as we'll give you some little time here at halftime, we'll take a break, be back in just
everybody
under 13
calm.
Minutes. Take a deep
everybody
breath.
Get a glass of water.
I'm going to go have some tea.
Okay.
All
I'll
right.
join you.
So that's Double H. I'm Hammer Abby. You are watching WFTDA.TV. We'll be back in about 12 and a half minutes.
Welcome back to the 2015 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Dallas, Texas. We are reliving some 90s music tales.
Spice Girls. why not?
We were dancing, so we spared you that, though. Our producer was nice enough to spare you all that. Thank you, Angela. So we needed to get some of that nervous energy out because the first period of this bout was just really tense. And it was one of those things where the energy was not fast. It was not a slow grind. It was somewhere in between, and it was a very measured pace. And I think maybe that's what makes it feel so tense and roller derby intense.
Yeah, well, because you don't know what to expect from either team. Like, is something about to happen? Are they about to change something up?
And it did have that feeling of something about to break at any moment, but things just kind of crept forward slowly. So let's talk a little bit about what did happen in the first period.
What did happen in the first period, Double H?
So one of the things that happened was that Philly had a lot of difficulty getting their jammers out. And so we discussed, as we came into the first period, the fact that Philly did have a fairly low lead jammer percentage on the season coming into this game, 42%, which was the second lowest, so not the lowest. Ohio had the lowest at 41%, but the second lowest coming into this playoff season. So, and 56% is right about where Rat City was sitting. And Luna Negra, I think, herself has a 74% lead jammer rate, which is awesome.
Yeah, although I will say in this game so far, she's only got a 43% lead jammer status.
And Philly has been able to shut her down, which has been helpful for them. But Rat City, on the other hand, has done an awesome job defensively. I have to say, Lacey Ramon, who is also known as Carmen Getsum, the captain, did such a fantastic job. Her communication on the track to her fellow blockers is just outstanding. It's very intuitive, and you can tell from a distance that she just knows exactly where everybody needs to go. She does have 2 penalties in this game, but Bots is sitting at 4. Bots has the highest number of penalties for Rad City right now, and on Philly's side, Tarantula has 5. Tarantula also an anchor of Philly's defense, so that could be a problem for them. But their main defensive problem right now is that outside line.
Yeah, absolutely. You're seeing Rat City's jammers really taking advantage of the fact that Philly hasn't been able to cover the outside line, a good foot off of it usually. And what's happening is they're getting around into their sort of more diamond or triangle formation, and the person on the line is sort of turning halfway, so they're not totally flush against the jammer who is oncoming. And that's just enough of a door to leave open that any good jammer is going to be able to take advantage of it. And so far, Rat City has definitely made some hay with that. They are 87 on the board for them. Philly at 65 as we're getting ready to get underway in the second half of this third place game on the third day of D1 championships here in Dallas, Texas.
Okay, so 3 in the front for Philly. They are moving back with Rat City, who has 4. Luna off the line is pushing, and she is lead jammer. Vanessa recycled on the outside at turn 1, drawn all the way back past the jammer line. And Lunacorn coming in on a scoring run finds the hips of Devoid of Mercy, now blocking for Philly. And Vanessa coming up against a really strong 3-wall braced by Lacey Ramon at the front. They are all roughly on the pivot line.
looking for a little bit of help. On the outside, Luna finds a nice space. There's that outside line again.
Yeah, and a five-point grand slam is Rat City's reward for that. Philly losing one blocker to the Derby Supply penalty box.
And Vanessa has taken the helmet cover off. She is able to make it outside. Nice whiff there. And that is going to be a sixth penalty for Tarantula in the Derby Supply penalty box, which is why Philly lost a blocker there.
Yeah, so in penalty trouble early in the second half right now, Tarantula sitting at six. That is a dangerous spot for her to be in, especially as a go-to clutch player for Philly. No one else in as much trouble on the team, though the next highest is three for Russian Bayou.
Rat City 96, Philly 65, 28 minutes and 37 seconds. We've got Gaska taking on Monster on the Fast Girl start line. At the back is Rat City with their four-person brace. Three people up front for Philly, broken apart. Meryl Stripper's got Gaska's number for a second, and then Ginger Vitus has to let her go. Herman Monster, meanwhile, recycled at turn one, just very casually tipping back is Beck, recycling all the way back. Oh. Gaska on the outside for 5 points.
Nice spin move around, deflecting the energy of the hit on her to get through. Great piece of footwork from Kayla Gaska.
Monster is through for her initial. Beautiful wedge there on the inside from Bots to open up a hole on the inside lane for her jammer.
Yeah, and essentially let Philly push Kayla Gaska through on the inside line, kind of using their own blockers to get her momentum up and through. So Rat City 105, Philly at 67 as we are underway in the second half now. And similar momentum to what we were seeing in the second half. So far, I haven't seen or felt a lot of change from Philly to try to speed things up here and catch up with the lead that Rat City has over them.
Jensen in the Derby Supply penalty box. So this is going to be a pack advantage for Philly, 4-on-3. This is 434 Wolf on the line taking on Xena.
The one name jammers.
One name versus one name. Wolf taken to the outside. Comes around looking for some space. Finds a hole on the inside. Jukes around. Gets lead jammer status for Philly.
Deflected a late hit there too. Still able to juke around it. In the meantime, Xena in the back taking a spill, has to go out and come back around.
Says, did I get knocked out of bounds? I should probably not risk it right now. Wolf right through the middle, coming up against the likes of Jensen, pushing forward at the last opposing blocker here for Rat City. That was Seaward. Now taking the helmet cover off to hand it to her pivot. Jensen now has the star for Rat City. That was Xena taking off the helmet cover. And through scoring points backwards, Wolf, number 434, grabs another couple of points for Philly Roller Derby.
Wow, taken out big time at the end there, though, by one. I misread the number. Was it gingivitis?
So many numbers.
I don't know. Someone did a great big hit.
Did you know everyone's wearing one?
I know. It's very confusing.
Right now, the number is most important. Rat City 105, Philly 76, 26 minutes on the clock. We've got V Diva Vanessa Seitz facing off against Luna Negra. Right around the outside, Luna looking for some room. Bunched up both of these jammers, offering an outside lane for their own jammer. Philly pushing Luna to the inside. Vanessa V Diva Seitz is lead jammer. Luna is able to make it through for her initial, just a little less than half a lap behind. And blocker's getting hung up at the back of the pack, coming around and grabbing a point for their jammer or two. Let's see how many points that's going to be for Vanessa. Again, she is requesting a certain number of points. She thinks she deserves 4, and her jammer referee says 3.
Starting to see a little bit more fire out of the blockers now and a little bit more intensity, which leading to some of those crashes that we're seeing around the turns. Coming alive in the second half. Could get dangerous if they're not careful to reel it in and make sure that it's clean play. But
at the last minute, Wax Poetic being waved to her bench, there is a blocker in the penalty box, and it is Meryl Stripper, I believe. So we have 4-on-3 pack advantage. Philly, but through for lead jammer status. That is Persephone on her toe stops.
This is the second lead jammer status for Philly in the second half, 2-3 for Rat City.
And this is Lacey Ramon for her first jam of the day. Kilmartin coming around on a scoring run, falling to the wayside at the back of the pack. One blocker from Philly.
And able to grab a point or two is Kilmartin. And that is going to be two.
Rydell skates roll faster and farther with their quick ceramic bearings. Part of the Rydell family. You want quick. You want quality. Think quick. That's what I meant to
say. I want both.
I want all of those things.
I want quick quality. Well, quick is probably what we'll get here off the Fast Girl start line with Kayla Gaska taking on Herman Monster. Philly trying to wall it up at the front. There was one opposing blocker lining up in their sights. And coming out of the penalty box is Meryl Stripper. So there is a four-person wall right around the outside, though. Herman Monster, lead jammer status for Philly Roller Derby.
Here's that switch of momentum that Philly desperately needs after the first half, trying to close the gap that Rat City was able to build in that first half of gameplay. Nice series of lead jammer statuses. Philly losing one blocker to the penalty box. That's going to be the pivot.
That is Ginger Vitus in the penalty box. Oh. Coming around is her sister, Herman Monster, on the inside, looking for some space, pushing forward, looks behind her, does see the pivot. That is Jensen holding the star cover and calls it off. Now that's going to be another 4 points. So here we go. Now we have 105 Rad City, 90 Philly, 23 minutes left in this game.
Point leader for the game right now, V Diva up at 38, Luna Negra right next door at 35. Wolf has 25 for Philly. Xena has 30 for Rat City.
So Genevieve Moore facing off against Vanessa, V Diva Sights. We've got a four wall in back from Rat City, a three person brace at the front, right through the inside though, Vanessa Sights lead jammer.
It's almost like Philly learned a lesson in the first half about what they could do with their jammers and exploit those open inside and outside lines against Rat City, although Rat was doing a much better job of covering it in the first half.
Oh, a destruction call in the midst of all that to one of Philly's blockers. There is a point scoring run in progress right now for Vanessa. She looks around to see where the opposing jammer is and calls it, again requesting a specific number of points.
Oh, and requested it accurately, 4 points. For Philly on that pass. So they are closing in on Rat City. 105 Rat City, 94 for Philly. Just under 22 minutes left in the second half of gameplay here. Hey, Sin City Skates, we wouldn't sell it if we wouldn't play in it. The first, the best, happy to fix the rest. That's SinCityskates.com.
Hello to the Rat's Nest and the folks watching the game there from Rat City Roller Girls.
I want some of their snacks.
Oh, that sounds delicious. Wolf facing off against Xena. Xena getting taken down on the inside. Wolf spinning around, looking to recycle. Xena is through to become lead jammer, but oh, right behind her, trying to get through. Wolf not able to do so. Now coming up behind her own blockers, getting a little bit of a whip from Meryl Stripper. Now she's got two to beat at turn three.
Oh man, came up against her own blockers, and that gave a chance for Rat to reform real quickly. Nice recycling work around to the front, stopping her cold in her tracks on the first straightaway now, having to recycle back around and re-enter.
So a full complement of blockers in the back now and in the front. Hopping in to give a little bit of assistance is Meryl Stripper in front, and that is where the pack is right now. So Philly's going to need to maintain that in the back, which they do. Xena getting forced down at turn one. Wolf taking the helmet cover off, pushing forward on this three-person brace.
She's got Beck to work her through the pack here as Beck got recycled back two, tries to play a little bit of offense. Looking for an opening to get her through.
Wolf is finally through on her initial. Xena still pushing against this wall. Meryl Stripper is the brace with Michelle Castro. Xena turns around. Russian Bayou just gives her a little hip bump at the end to send her to her knees. Just as a parting gift.
How do you do?
This is how you will exit that jam, but gets a back block.
I wonder. That was, so Xena was turned away from her at that point, so the contact would have been illegal. Bont skates lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. You can also check out My Bonts for the latest and greatest way to customize your Bont skates.
Vanessa Sights versus the Lunicorn. 114.94, 19 minutes and 45 seconds left. Taken on the outside, the Lunicorn. Vanessa Sights up front has three to beat, and she does lead jammer Philly.
Yeah, nice heads-up play there by Devoid of Mercy, blocking the outside line, so Luna Negra wasn't able to get through. She is through on her initial pass now, though.
Vanessa Seitz coming up against the likes of Lacey and taken down, holding her face. There's going to be a call on it.
That's a low block on V-Diva. She went down, and that was her head contacted the bottom of the skates of the Rat City player. So she will spend some time in the Derby Supply penalty box for Philly. Now power jam for Rat.
So we've only got three blockers on the track as well for Philly. Doing some damage up front. Nice waterfall assist here. Russian Bayou says no, not so fast. Gives her a little hit.
Luna Negra just bowls her down, though, so through for another five-point grand slam for Rat City.
So lining up like a pace line, Rat City's blockers. Luna through on the inside, though. Philly's blockers totally focused on that offensive pick they thought were coming, but Carmen gets them moving forward. And coming through the inside, Luna just says, out of my way.
Three triangle in the front of Philly blockers. Luna Negra backing off, reapproaching, trying again.
Vanessa back in action. She takes the star off, eyeing up the pivot. Devoid of Mercy, who is now performing some defense. Vanessa through on the outside under toe stops, is going to get an additional 4 points for Philly.
Philly losing their pivot to the Derby Supply penalty box for a penalty in that last play. And also Rat City's pivot has gone straight to the penalty box.
Hops through the inside for five more points for Philly. And that brings Philly above 100. Rat City 129, Philly 103. 3 seconds left. Vanessa still scoring points.
Oh, Luna Negra looks like she had the wind knocked out of her on that last pass. Bent over right now. She heads to her bench. A hard jam. Nice work, though. Scoring points. So Rat City at 133, Philly at 107. Rat holding onto a lead. Not a comfortable one necessarily, but a decently sized one for Philly to make up. But Philly definitely coming back, putting on the afterburners in the second half of gameplay here.
So Kilmartin back on the fast girl start line for Philly. Gaska for Rat City. Gaska eyeing up that outside line one more time. Ginger Vitus is right there. Coming up against the likes of Tarantula, though. Gaska through on the outside. Lead jammer, Rat City.
Oh, and a crashing, almost slide tackle on the outside there. Kilmartin going down, having to get back up, come back around.
Ginger Vitus just taking out blockers, turns around to notice that she needs to be defense now, and coming around on a scoring run is Kilmartin. There's going to be a call off, but a back block being assessed as well. See who that is given to.
Everybody's headed toward the bench right now. I can't tell who that is.
It is going to be... That's not Gaska. No, it's not Gaska.
No, so the pivot for Rat City sitting in the penalty box right now, and the only one after everything shook out in the box. So a little chaotic ending to that jam. People going down left and right. And there is a timeout. I'm not entirely surprised to see that. That's going to be an official review.
Okay.
On the track.
It is going to be to Rat City's official review.
Very interesting. S1 Helmets. Be a lifer, get a lifer. That's S1 Helmets. They're rad, get rad. And by the way, some information for you. The WFTDA Recognized Tournaments Program supports high-quality tournaments hosted by WFTDA members worldwide. Applications for Recognized Tournament Program are open until September 30th. If your league is hosting a tournament this year, learn more about this program and apply at wftda.com/events.
So we will hear from Mr. Frangiosa.
Rat City is requesting a cutting the track call on the Philadelphia Jammer.
All right, Rat City 136, Philly 107. And so Vince Hannity asks the question, has Philly Roller Derby, that's their Twitter handle, PRG Skates, ever failed to qualify for WFTDA championships before? Well, we can answer that question pretty easily. The answer here is 2008, third place at champs. 2009, lost in the quarterfinals. 2010, they were there. 11, 12, 13, 14. So since 2008, the answer is
No.
They have always gone to championships. So if they lose this, this will break quite a streak for them. And again, would represent a bit of an upset this weekend. Rat City seeded a little bit lower than Philly by one. So Philly came in as the 3 seed, Rat City the 4 seed. And also 4 rankings below Philly in the WFTD rankings. So, yeah, this would be a pretty good upset for Rat.
To review, the Philadelphia Jammer was knocked to the ground. However, she never touched out of bounds. Therefore, there is no cut. Thank you.
No, thank you, Judge Knott. Thank you. And thank you to all the officials.
All right. We'll get back to the action here. Xena lining up for Rat City. Going up against this Herman Monster.
Herman Monster. In the back is Philly. Vanessa Vidiva Seitz is acting as the bridge right now and the pivot, performing some offense. That is number 53, Raven Seward, holding her face after that moment. And Vanessa acting as the brace for the final line of defense here on Philly's line.
Such smart defensive work from Rat City, though. Nice bridge work. Just immediately everybody falling into the place they need to be. Recycling around, hitting her to the outside, and that's going to give some time. Xena out front, picking up lead jammer status. And meanwhile, Herman Monster grabbing a forearm call headed to the Derby. I'm sorry, a cut call headed to the Derby Supply penalty box. So power jam for Rat City.
So Philly a little bit slow to pull their wall together here, and as a result, coming right around with speed was Xena, and now they are recycling her all the way back. That is number 06, Castro. So the three-person brace at the front trying to maintain its integrity, now rejoined by Castro, and there is an additional blocker at the front, and that is Seward.
This is the second power jam of the game for Rat City, because Philly's jammers have been so clean so far, but still not enough for them to regain a lead. Oh, close. Nice try by V-Diva there to pull the track cut, but Xena comes in just legally.
And they do have her on the outside finally, but that is going to be a high block assessed to Vanessa, going to the penalty box now. Monster out of the Derby Supply penalty box for her initial. Takes advantage of the chaos and gets through.
Woo!
Xena grabs some points, but she doesn't look very happy about it.
That was a blistering jam for her, so I'm not entirely surprised to see her taking a minute to recombobulate herself.
So, we've got on the Fast Girl start line, Luna Negra coming up against Wolf for Philly. And we've got Rat City in the front, Philly in the back. We've got 3 blockers in back from Philly. Wolf finding a line around the outside. Tarantula, though, managing to catch Luna on the inside. Wolf pushing forward on this 4-person brace. Nice diamond defense as Russian Bayou going to the penalty box. This is going to be her 5th penalty. So Wolf finds an open lane and takes it. Lead jammer Philly. Luna Negra recycled on the inside. And there's only 2 blockers on the track now for Philly. For a full complement for Seattle. Right around the outside,
oh.
Wolf. And she takes a hit, turns around, and calls it. Let's see how many she comes away with after that.
Nice job by M. Jensen, pivot in the Rat City pack, as the first blocker wasn't able to catch her on the outside line, but she was immediately there to hit her out. Nice 1-2 punch.
Catechism asking, gets 2 points for Philly there on that one. Wolf does.
And the WFTD would like to thank this weekend Sin City Skates, 5-on-5 Magazine, Something Inked, Derby Central, and of course our hosts, the Dallas Derby Devils, putting on such a fine show this weekend.
Kayla Gaska jamming against Kilmartin, who comes up against her own blocker on the way to Rat City's line.
Big smile on Kayla Gaska's face as she was skating that lap around. Finds the outside and blasts past Philly's blockers, almost untouched. That's going to be a nickel that she picks up for
Kilmartin, still working on that front wall, gets recycled on the inside. Kayla Gaska coming up against Russian Bayou, turns around and calls it. She probably could have gone a lot farther than that hammer.
Yeah, interesting that she called it off so quickly, but, you know, can't question the bench, so that's what they decide. But could have pulled that jam for a little bit longer, put up more points for her team, because Philly was still having a hard time getting their jammer through. And Philly, yep, a little bit of penalty trouble here. Tarantula still sitting at 6, Russian Bayou at 5. Now, like you said, V Diva has 3, some of which were accrued as a pivot.
So Genevieve Moore, number 243 for Rat City, jamming against Herman Monster. Through on the inside, lead jammer Rat City. Herman Monster still trying to find some room on the outside to work with. Getting a little bit of assistance from Ginger Vitus. She hops forward, and that is going to be just such solid work from Rat City, reforming those walls in the front. Once they're broken, they are reforming. And they are reforming in such a solid way in the back. Recycled is Genevieve Moore. Hopping forward to the inside is Tarantula, who gives a tiny bop. And then joins her teammates at the back, working on Genevieve Moore. Oh, hit by Tarantula on the inside, turn 4.
Got a push from one of her teammates there, but it just put her right in the target of Tarantula, knocked her out. So interesting to see Rat's defensive work. They played Rose earlier, and they didn't win the game, but they really gave Rose a run for their money through the first half of the game. Really tight defensive work.
And Monster able to scratch a couple away out of that, I believe. But that's going to be a 5-point pass.
Oh, no.
Sorry, no, she wasn't.
So I'm looking at the point differentials here, and that tells a bit of the story. So over on Philly Roller Girl, they've had 5 jammers out there so far, 4 of which have a negative point differential, which means that points are being scored against them that sort of take away the effectiveness of the points they're able to score. Only 2 of the 5 jammers that Rat has jammed have a negative differential, and it's a small one.
So Luna Negra off against V Diva. Philly taking the back, and in the front, a brace 3 wall from Seattle, and Vanessa, looking for a way around, finds a little hole and is able to maintain her balance. Lead jammer status for Philly. Lunacorn in the midst of the pack, still trying to get around. Heard a whistle, wasn't sure if it was her. She's looking for a little bit of help from her blockers. And right around the outside, Philly's blockers try to meet her, aren't entirely able to stop her, so she's through on her initial. Vanessa gets taken out between turns 2 and 3 and calls it. And we're going to grab a couple more points for Philly. So now the score, Rat City 154, Philly 114, 9 minutes and 30 seconds left in this game.
156 for Rat City, actually,
yes.
Now 114 for Philly. And fun to note, so V Diva and Luna Negra have faced each other on the line a number of times. They are the top 2-point scorers for either team. V Diva at 62, Luna Negra at 54 total points in this game.
So updated to 156-116. And we've got Wolf facing off against Gaska. Wolf coming up against a 3-person wall. Gaska on the inside, lead jammer status. Those lines are her lanes tonight. And jumping forward, Wolf setting up for a pick on the inside was Rat City, but the 3 wall was able to move around. And oh, at least a point scored there from Wolf. And Gaska's going to be asked by her bench to continue. Wolf is through on a scoring run. Walling it up at the back is Philly. An additional blocker joins Gaska. Gaska taken out by Ginger Vitus, and there's going to be a call off finally for 4 more points.
So that cleared the box for both teams, mm-hmm. but Kayla holding onto it long enough to bring out one of their blockers. So both teams will be at full capacity for the next jam.
So a 43-point difference here with just 18 minutes and 15 seconds on the clock.
Woo! So Philly clearly making some adjustments at the halftime, but still having such trouble covering those lines. And Rat City's defense just making a short work of some of their jammers. And
Xena taking on Kilmartin. The back line is still Philly. Kilmartin taken out at turn 1. And through 4 lead jammer, there's going to be a cutting call assessed to Kilmartin, and this is now a power jam Xena.
So I wondered about that. Kilmartin stood, got knocked down and clearly had gone out of bounds, but when she stood up, both feet were in bounds, even though she immediately then left the track.
So Xena still working on this 4-person brace. Rat's offense just hops forward on the inside like a freight train and opens up that hole. Teflon Donna trying to work the outside. The helmet cover comes off, and Xena pushes it towards Lacey.
Lacey finding some room on the outside to where it comes right up against Devoid of Mercy. Michelle Castro and Mercy try to grab her, and they do not.
Yeah, went out of bounds with her, so good heads-up play from Lacey there. That's going to be a five-point grand slam for Rat City, by the way. Both teams have three jammer box trips.
Big push forward from Raven Seaward opening a hole. Kilmartin trying to make it through. There's going to be a cutting call in there.
Yeah, Lacey Ramon for Rat City now in the Derby Supply penalty box, and the tables have turned. Philly has the power jam opportunity for Kilmartin back on the track.
They are going to have to spring their jammer if they're going to want it to happen. Lots of carpet unraveling happening in the pack. Wax Poetic jumping forward to try to help out Kilmartin. Kilmartin taken to the inside. She's got two to beat. Finally does on one skate backwards.
Yeah, no big deal.
NBD.
So this was the first jammer penalty of the second half for Rat City. Lacey back on the track and through for 5 points real quickly out of the box there.
Kilmartin just mohawking around. And there's going to be a call at the last minute against Evans. So we're going to talk about some points. The officials are actually conferring right now about how many points each of these teams have nabbed. So we've got 5 minutes and 45 seconds left in this game. Will it be enough for Philly to make up that 50-point difference?
Jackson, skate for the love of it. That's Jackson skates.
We've got Luna Negra taking on V Diva. Four-person wall in the back from Philly. Three-person wall in the front from Rat, and Vanessa springs forward, gets taken to the outside, recycled all the way back to the jammer line. Luna Negra being held now at the back. Vanessa looking for an open lane on the inside, finds it, lead jammer status Philly.
Luna Negra not too far behind, though, about a half a track, maybe a little bit less, giving chase around the track as both of the packs speeding up a little bit here, fighting with one another, holding back a Rat blocker. Nice bit of goading, as we call it.
And Vanessa absolutely aware of where her opposing jammer is.
168 Rat City, 126 for Philly. About 4.5 minutes left in the second half of the game. Philly doing some work in the second half, trying to close in on the lead that Rat opened up early in the game. Not able to close in just yet, and time running short.
Herman Monster, number 152, on the Fast Girl start line for Philly Roller Derby against Missile America, a.k.a. Kayla Gaska, number 321 for Rat. And we've got 3-on-4 pack advantage Philly, but Monster taken out on the outside line. Rat with that closure on the outside lanes 1 and 4 tonight has been spectacular. Getting a little help on the inside from Russian Bayou. Herman Monster through to become lead jammer.
Kayla Gaska right behind found that outside line open, though, giving chase. It's going to be jammer, unjammer, very quick approach to the pack here. Rat City getting up to the front, but their pivot being held back.
Philly trying to grab a point, and will they? They will. That was a very difficult point to fight for.
Performance plates for the modern derby game that's Powerdyne. Cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance, Powerdyne.
3 minutes and 35 seconds left in this game, and Philly puts Wolf on the Fast Girl start line against Luna Negra. We've got a 5-on-5 in this track right now, I should say on this track. In the back wall, Philly, that four-person brace up at the front. We've also got a four-person brace for Rat City. The pack integrity still maintained. Wolf working the outside line, pushes forward, gets taken out at turn one, narrowly avoids the cutting call, but that's going to be Tarantula headed out for her seventh penalty, and she is fouling out of this game. Luna Negra lead jammer, Wolf out right behind her, about a third of a lap behind, and the pack starts racing.
So yeah, that early penalty trouble starting to catch up with Philly a little bit here, although Wolf so far notably having a clean game.
Luna Negra very careful here. She does not want to get any penalties. It's going to be a handful of points there for Luna and one for Wolf.
There was some call on the track by Philly players trying to ask for something to be called, and now looking like they're going to be taking a timeout.
Skating out of bounds, perhaps, on the part of Rat City's jammer, Luna Negra.
the Lunacorn.
And sure enough, here come the captain and the A headed to the center of the track to have a chat with the referees. So this might turn into an official review. I'm not sure right now. No, they're going to head back now. They're done. They just wanted to look at the referees for a minute.
It's entirely possible, knowing Paul Williams, that he said, "You saw that, right? You saw what I saw, right? Okay, just checking. I don't want to have to make this an official review. Do I have to? No? Okay."
So, yeah.
Oh, truth. They don't have one.
They can't
use it.
Can't
do it.
No,
Philly has one review left. Rat City does not.
2.5 minutes left in the game. Rat City, that's the overhead view you're seeing there, sitting on a comfortable lead, 171 to 128, looking to stamp their ticket to championships in St. Paul in November, which would upset the higher-seeded Philly team and be the first time Philly doesn't go to championships since 2009. But we still have 2.5 minutes left of play.
Oh, they were at championships in 2009.
I'm sorry.
They hosted championships
since before 2009.
Do-do-do-do-do.
I misspoke.
Declaration of Derby it was.
Oh,
I remember it well.
I remember it well. Well, you do. I don't.
Just like it was yesterday.
I'm glad that I have you here, Double H.
I'm glad to be here, Hammurabi. And here we go. We've got right around the outside lead jammer status
and
for
a
Rat City.
Nope, that was a cutting call.
No.
Wasn't clean. She tiptoed up that outside line and managed to step out. So a power jam for Philly and V Diva.
So this is an opportunity that they have been waiting for. 3-on-4 pack advantage still for Rat, but right around the outside. Lead jammer status goes to Vanessa Seitz. Let's see what she can do here. We've got 171 Rat City, 128 Philly. 2 minutes left on this game clock.
V Diva still the point leader of this game at 65, looking to open that up a little bit more.
Huge waterfall on the inside from Philly, opening up the inside lane.
We'd need a Sandrine Rangel level of jam here, though, point scoring wise, for this to close in on Rat City's lead. Still
coming up against this four-person brace, Vanessa stumbles for a moment, pushing forward. Out of the penalty box, though, is Gaska.
Both jammers dealing with very, very tight defensive formations, these dynamic box formations four against one on each side. V-Diva trying to find an opening behind Rat here and just not getting any luck.
And she's looking behind her to see where the rest of the pack is. I think she needs a little bit of assistance. Devoid of Mercy trying to offer her some. And she finds enough of a break to try to get around. She's forced to the infield, clutching her face. And there may be a call on that.
That was Leanne Evans with the drawback.
And there's going to be a low block assessed to Gaska. She's going to the Derby Supply penalty box. Vanessa Seitz on her scoring run.
Pivot for Rat City also headed to the Derby Supply penalty box, so they're down a blocker as well. A nice heads-up play around there. Still has V-Diva in the pack as they're trying to play some offense here, but Rat speeding up to keep her in control.
Teflon Donna offering her some assistance. And so we've got 28 seconds left.
Nice penalty kill there by Rat City as they ran into two jammer penalties in a row. Really kept V-Diva to low scoring on that. So timeout for Philly here. As you see Rat embracing on the track, feeling pretty good with just 27 seconds left on the clock. Looking like a likely Rat City win in this game.
30-point game here, Rat City 171, Philly 141. We've got time for one more jam.
We do, in fact. I can tell you real quick. So like we said, Tarantula has fouled out of the game. 7 penalties on Philly Roller Girls. Russian Bayou at 5 is the next closest. Over on Rat City, Lacey Ramon in a little bit of a trouble toward the end of the game, up at 6. But otherwise, scattered and low penalties. Some clean players in this game as well, and congratulations to them. V-Diva still up at 78 points, so the point scorer leader in this game, Luna Negra at 57 is next behind that Missile America at 50.
Oh, and there is going to be an official. No, you can't take an official review.
Well, someone's making an official review.
They're using their official review as a timeout.
Ah,
okay.
There you go.
So, which you can do, and that is exciting.
27 seconds
exactly.
Left on the clock. I'm not entirely sure it's going to make a difference at this point. And I don't want to, you know, I don't like to poo-poo, but clock management certainly a part of the game. But when you've got this little bit of a time, I guess, you know, a 30-point lead, if you have an enormous jam, you can make it up. So it's not outside the realm of possibility, but also high probability of not happening.
I think Rat City's defense is making that slightly less probable.
Yes.
Because their defense has been absolutely on point in this game. And where it's mattered the most has been lanes 1 and 4.
Yeah.
And even though they have a braced wall, they are right there on the lanes to shut them down on the inside and the outside. And that has been one place where Philly has struggled the entire game.
Yeah, great lateral movement by Rat City blockers, sort of using that 45-degree angle so that when they pop over to the lines, they're popping up and in front of the momentum of the jammers that are oncoming, doing really great heads-up work. Or if one misses, the next one is there right away to cover.
So we are starting this as a power start. Vanessa V-Diva Sites on the line for Philly. Gets through. She is lead jammer. And now standing in the penalty box is Gaska. A wall at the back from Philly. This is the square formation, the box jumping forward. Vanessa Sites says, I don't have any time. I've got points to score. She grabs 5.
Man, would have been interesting to see that amount of intensity earlier, able to break up these packs like that. But
and there's going to be a back block called, assessed against Vanessa Sites.
They're not following through on the call.
And so maybe it's waved off by the jammer referee. The audience is extremely unhappy with that, but pushing forward is Vanessa.
Looking up for a little bit of help here from one of her pack mates, playing some offense, trying to break up Rat's defense. Rat very calmly reforming in front of her, though.
And so a minute left on the clock. Vanessa's going to have to work a little bit faster if she's going to be able to break and make any headway here. And she is getting through, finally, on a scoring run. Gaska goes down at turn one, holding her hip.
Ooh.
She's recycled all the way back, slowly, in pain.
Had that big breakaway sprint, and that last-minute hit took her out. Took a lot out of her from the looks of it. V-Diva now getting hit out and recycled back to turn one as well. The period clock is done. We are on jam time alone right now. Rat City 171, Philly at 150.
And Gaska making through on her scoring run. An additional 4 points. Vanessa pushing on the inside. 15 seconds left in this game. She's taken out at turn one. Recycled all the way back to the jammer line. That is Carmen Getsam, Lacey Ramon who does it. 5 seconds left. Scoring points on the inside. Vanessa coming up to the middle. Rat City ending this one victorious. We shall see the final point count here.
Wow, yeah, so real interesting game. Rat City just nice and calm through most of it. Really excellent defensive work, as we've been talking about. It was those lines. They were so good at covering the lines, the outside and the inside, whereas Philly was having trouble letting Rat City's jammers through up those lines, unable to cover them in time. So, you know, a great game to watch for just excellent defensive strategy work there from Rat City.
So their defense, I think, a huge story. When we saw them play Rose City, we definitely saw, you know, Rat City is a team that learns quickly.
Yeah.
So one of the things that Rat City was doing consistently in their game against Rose City is using that additional blocker to kind of mess with the line off the whistle. They didn't do it as much here, but they were so successful in that lateral movement, as you said, and shutting it down. And one of the things that they were having a problem with in their game against Rose City was staying forward, staying stable, maintaining those lines, maintaining the integrity of those walls, and they nailed it in this game.
Absolutely. And we can look at the stats from the different halves of the game here and see sort of this tale unfold. So in the first half, Philly scored 65 points. They were able to increase that in the second half to 89, but Rat 87 and 91, pretty even. Lead jammer statuses for Philly in the first were 9, and the second half went up to 11, so again improved. Rat City went from 13 to 10, but still pretty stable in the middle there. And then box trips by jammers in the first half, none from Philly, 3 in the second half, 3 in the first half for Rat, and just 2 in the second half. So again, we look at these, they're fairly close numbers, Philly able to improve in the second half, so it comes right back to that tail of the defense. Really, really excellent work. V-Diva still the point leader in this game, though, 91 points, second only in Luna Negra at 57. So although V-Diva was able to score that, like, at 91 of her team's 154 points, not enough. Rat City with just good, consistent play across the board.
But what was her lead jammer percentage in this game? We'll take a look at that, because as we mentioned coming into this tournament, that was a problem with Philly's season, is that they had been around 42%. I think Vanessa herself had been around 55% on the season. So that had been a problem for them jammer-wise coming into this playoffs situation. So Vanessa, even though she was able to score 91 points,
she had a 69% lead jammer, so slightly good. Better than average. Yeah, was doing pretty well. And Luna Negra, slightly lower. I'm trying to look at too many things at once. Too many screens.
There are too many things to see.
All of the stats.
And there were too many things to see in this game. So a big win for Rat City, headed to championships. Philly Roller Derby not heading to championships for the first time since 2007. 2008 is the last championship, the very first championships that they participated in. So
yeah, a bit of an upset today. Congratulations to Rat City for punching their ticket to championships. And we are getting ready now. You don't want to go anywhere. WFTDA.tv, the first place match coming up next against the number ones and one and two seeds. That is the Wheels of Justice, Rose City, up against the Texas Roller Girls, Texecutioners, taking the track right now to get warmed up. And it is certain to be a fantastic game.
All right. Well, I am Double H here with Hammer Abby. We are going to send it down to the floor. And it looks like our friend Electra Blue is going to be interviewing the Lunacorn.
Hi there, this is Electra Blue. I am joined by Luna Negra. So excited, so much excitement. And Captain Carmen, Lacey. So lots of action happening here. Lots of tears just a moment ago. I caught you just at the end of it. So you came into this tournament rostered as Luna Negra, but we've been told to call you Lunacorn. Tell me a little bit about this.
My team loves me and they think they're funny, and so we all have nicknames for each other and it's all love, and somehow I got Lunacorn, and I have a pet unicorn named Jeremy.
Jeremy, it's your pet unicorn?
It's my baby. Yeah, I don't like unicorns at all.
You don't even like unicorns? Yet you're a Lunacorn.
Sorry,
unicorn
world,
so it's not gonna, it's not sticking. This has just been a little fun that your team has been having on you.
Yeah, I had no idea.
So you've just punched your tickets to champs. So exciting. Last year you made it to D1. Previously, from 2006, you made it all the way to championships. What was the difference this year to get you now from just getting to D1 last year and now getting this far, now punching your ticket to champs?
Honestly, this woman right here put in a lot of work before the season started. She wouldn't say it, but she's been planning for years for this moment. And I really appreciate it. Her and our coach have been making us work our tails off, and it's finally paid off. And all of our team put in 100% heart and soul, and we all had to believe it, and I really feel like today we came together.
Absolutely. I'm just happy. I'm just so happy we worked so hard. I mean, we have 10 new players on our charter that weren't here last year, so 8 of them skated this weekend, and we came together as a team. It's rad.
Well, that's huge. So it was a rebuilding. 2015 was a rebuilding year. You had a pretty aggressive season. You played 9 games trying to get ready for this. You played some of our old favorites here, you know, that have been around for a while. So now you've got a couple of months break. What happens?
We work. We got work to do.
Real we're hard.
Coming. Yeah, we're coming. That's been the goal this whole season. We have jammers that are trying for my spot, that are trying for starting jammer position, who want to do it all at champs. And so... We have depth, and we're coming for people, because I'm excited.
So when I caught you in your tears after everything, you were saying, no, I don't know, I sucked. Luna, you did not suck. 57 points
really?
in that game. Only 2 penalties. I don't think that's sucking so much.
It doesn't matter. We have jammers who came in and filled in when I wasn't getting lead and who carry things when I wasn't feeling it. We had people step up. Our blocker stepped up. I can feel like I sucked. But then we have other people who can come in and take that job and get it done. And so that's what happened today.
Well, that's what's, having a strong bench. Your 10 new skaters obviously worked really hard. You punched your ticket to champs. Now you can go, I don't know, have a beer, maybe? Rest? I don't know.
We're going to... The kids don't know beers, but yeah. We're excited. We're going to go celebrate for sure. Yeah.
Well, I don't want to keep you from celebrating. We're going to watch this game now at 6 o'clock. This is Texas versus Rose for the number one seed. Stay tuned at WFTDA.tv.